couple weeks ago, you know, there was the top ranked card with the two of their lightweight stars, and you had Yokoyas Gamboa beat Roger Mataguia in very, very, very impressive fashion. And then you had the main event, Juan Manuel Lopez fighting, going up just one weight class above Gamboa to fight the a title. Steve Lovano, you know, a belt holder in that area. Now, he won impressively too, but, you know, we talked a little bit about these guys, not a whole lot, but, you know, they're two top-ranked guys, and the idea is to, what it seemed like last year, was to eventually have them keep on fighting
the same card. The second card they fought on, right?
Well, I think it's even more than that, and then they would eventually fight each other, but I think that, you know, you see that you got really two skilled guys here, and you don't want to, you know, cancel each other out. So they're not going to, I don't think, fight this year, 2010. But I tell you what, you and I both have opinions on who would win if they fought now. And so we'd like to hear your opinions. What do you think?
Well, Gamboa, I mean, he just blew through a guy that pretty much beat Lopez, or almost beat him, mm-hmm. the last time they fought. So, you know, everything he threw, I mean, it was like, you got a house fighter against a championship fighter in Gamboa when he fought Mataguia, is that how you pronounce it? I mean, I thought it was going to be, you know, kind of a longer fight. I mean, it almost was over in the first round. I mean, obviously, he got him in the second round, but he did enough damage in a round and a half, two rounds, that maybe Lopez gave him in a full 12 rounds when they fought. You know, I mean, it was tough to watch. I mean, I thought they could have stopped it after the first round. He took so many big shots. And, you know, obviously he couldn't take him. And then Lopez, I mean, he beat a more solid opponent, a tough guy, obviously, you know, not an A-plus fighter, but maybe a B-plus fighter, guy that never really fought anybody that high of caliber. And it was a closer fight, but you could tell the tide was turning. Ultimately caught him with, like, some sort of uppercut from outside. I mean, it was pretty far away, but
yeah, I mean,
I just don't see those punches landing on Gamboa. And I think if the two fight, you know, I'll go with Gamboa, and you know, I think it's a blowout.
I
don't even think it's gonna be close.
I think you put, you know, and that's not even.
and Lopez is a solid fighter, but I just don't think Gamboa will be there when he throws a punch. And I think Gamboa's got, he's so fast and so much power that it's gonna do some damage. And what's his name's not gonna know where he's at.
Yeah, Juan Manuel Lopez. Maybe he said, or maybe Bob Arum said, hey, you know, I can't. I mean, you know. Gamboa will kill him, because the thing that I saw and that I have seen is Gamboa, you know, is definitely someone who's been knocked down more and has more of a, you know, suspect chin than Lopez. Okay, but definitely, you know, I mean, the guy is just, you know, one you'd want to have your side,
like
on your side.
It's like a Pacquiao.
He's
being power.
I mean, he's just really impressive. And the thing that I, like I said, that I'm seeing him kind of graduate in a way that he's taken that experience of being knocked down to his advantage in his future fights, and not left his chin dangling out there and been too reckless and try to, you know, when you have that much power and skill, mm-hmm. it, you know, it's real easy to kind of think that you can take him out. But he usually does take him out, mm-hmm. You know, and Lopez, again, you know, like
more
you said,
textbook, more traditional type fighter. But, you know, you're finding a guy that's more explosive. I mean, he's not going to be there to take your 1-2, your 1-2-3s. You're going to throw him, he'll be gone, he'll counter, you'll get stunned, you know, he'll just keep on you. And I don't, how do you see it? I don't know, I think Gamboa.
Oh, yeah, I think Gamboa, big time, like you said. I mean, but like I said, that's not to say that Lopez is
no,
stiff.
He's
because,
great.
Because I think you put, you know, 9.9 out of 10 guys in Gamboa's, you know, in front of Gamboa, and he'll take him out. Mm-hmm. You know, so, yeah, I mean, let us know who you think, if they're not going to fight, okay, or if they're going to fight, and we wish they're going to fight this year, but they're not, who would win, and how, and why. And then, if they're not going to fight, who would you like to see them fight now here in the next couple fights for 2010? You know, I mean...
Yeah, who else is in that weight class?
Nobody really wants to fight Gamboa.
About those two.
But Lopez, you know, now that he's, you know, moved up in that weight, you know, maybe there's some more intriguing matchups there, so...